Bismillahirrahmanirrahim, my dear students. Here is your mathematics teacher Muhammad Amjad Saeed from Pakistan International School, Taif, Saudi Arabia. Today we will continue our lecture number 40. And as I told you before, inshallah, now I am going to start our chapter number 8. In chapter number 8, we are given two theorems, theorem number 1 and theorem 2. And after that, we are given some question from exercise 8.12 and miscellaneous exercise. I will write down this theorem one by one, theorem number 1 and 2 first, and then we will move to our exercise questions. Chapter number 8, theorem number 8.1. What is the statement? A big statement. In an obtuse angle triangle, the scale on the side opposite to obtuse angle is equal to sum of scales on the sides containing the obtuse angle together with twice the rectangle contained by one of the sides and the projection on it of the other. Basically, in obtuse angle triangle, we are given obtuse angle triangle. You know what is meant by obtuse angle triangle? A triangle whose one angle is greater than 90 degrees. One angle is greater than 90 degrees. That triangle is known as obtuse angles triangle. Here is A, B, and C. With usual notation, opposite to capital A, we have small a, opposite to C is small c, and opposite to B is small b. The statement says that in an obtuse angle triangle, the side opposite to obtuse angle, the scale on the side opposite to obtuse angle is equal to sum of the scales of the sides of angle, sum of the scales of sides of the angle, and together with twice together with the twice the rectangle contained by one of the side and projection of it on the other. So we have what is given. What is given? In a obtuse triangle ABC, angle A is obtuse angle in such a way that BC is equal to A, AB is equal to C, AC is equal to B. Draw CD perpendicular to BA produced. Draw CD perpendicular means making 90 degree. So draw CD perpendicular to BA produced in such a way that AD is equal to X and CD is equal to H. Dear students, again listen carefully. What is given? Triangle ABC is a obtuse triangle at obtuse angle at A such that AB is equal to C, BC is equal to A, AC is equal to B. Draw CD perpendicular to BA produced such that CD is equal to H and AD is equal to X, where AD is the projection of AC on BA produced. Again, in triangle ABC, angle A is obtuse angle such that BC is equal to A, AB is equal to C, AC is equal to B, draw CD perpendicular to BA produced such that AD is equal to X, CD is equal to H, where AD is projection of AC on, projection mean image on the ground. This is AC, its projection is on ground, on BA produced. So AD is the projection of AC on BA produced. Now to prove is, BC square is equal to AC square plus AB square plus 2AB AD twice, together with twice the side as rectangle and projection on the other. So we have, again to prove is, BC square is equal to AB square plus AC square plus 2 into AB into AD. Or you can say, dear students, you can say A square is equal to B square plus C square plus 2CX. A square is equal to B square plus C square plus 2CX. So this is to prove. After that, we have proof. In case of proof, dear students, I am writing down only proof so that you can understand. You can take help from your book. If you open up the book and listen to my words, what I was telling to you, so you can easily understand that one. Okay? So proof is statements and reasons. I am again saying that this is not the complete theorem. Remember that. Don't consider this complete theorem and don't write down this only. You have to write down given, you have to write down to prove, and you have to write down construction if there is construction. So proof is statement. Okay? In triangle CDA. In triangle CDA, angle D is 90 degrees, therefore you can apply Pythagoras theorem. Remember that in triangle ACD, angle ADC is equal to 90 degrees. Therefore, AC square is equal to AD square plus CD square. This is Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem, remember that. Here is, you can say B square is equal to X square plus A square. This is equation number 1. Dear students, you can check. What about BD? BD is actually C plus X. This is C, this is X, the total is C plus X. Now, in right triangle BCD, listen, in right triangle BCD, this is big triangle, which is right angle triangle. Angle BDC is equal to 90 degrees. Remember that this angle BDC is 90 degrees. So using Pythagoras theorem, we can say BC square is equal to BD square and plus CD square. This is Pythagoras theorem. What about BC square? That is, A square is equal to, what about BD? BD means C plus X whole square. And CD is H square. Dear students, A square is equal to, what will be? C square plus X square plus 2CX plus H square. This is equation number 2. Now you can check, A in place of x square plus y, x square plus h square, you can apply its value as b square. Again, in this equation number 2, x square plus h square, this is equation number 1, x square plus h square is equal to b square, therefore replacing, you can say using 1 in equation 2. So what you will get, a square is equal to c square plus b square plus 2cx. You can say a square is equal to b square plus c square plus 2cx. I told you a square is equal to b square plus c square plus 2cx. That was your theorem number 8.1. I hope that you understood this theorem. Dear students, after that we have theorem number 2. Theorem number 2. Consult your book and try to understand the steps what I have told you this year. Exercise, rather theorem number 2. That is, you can say 8.2. The statement of this theorem is, in any triangle, the square on the side opposite to acute angle is equal to the sum of squares of the sides containing the acute angle diminished by twice the rectangle contained by one of those sides and projection on it by the other, of the other. Dear students, what is the difference from theorem number 8.1? The difference is that in theorem 8.1, obtuse angle triangle was given. In theorem 8.1, obtuse angled triangle was given. But in case of theorem 8.2, acute angle triangle is given. In 8.1, that was together with twice. Together with twice means plus 2cx. And in case of 8.2, diminished by twice. Diminished means minus. So, dear students, this is very, very simple and very similar to the theorem number 8.1, in fact. And you know that what is meant by acute angle triangle. Acute angle triangle means the triangle whose angles are less than 90 degrees. Angles are less than 90 degrees. Here is A, B, and C. I told you opposite to A, A. Opposite to B is B, and opposite to C is C. And that is acute angle. Here is acute angle at A. So what is given? C is this one. Here is B is the length of side of C. And this one also. And here is, this is x. So definitely if this is equal to c, then this is x. So what about bd? Bd will be equal to ab minus ad, that is c minus x. In triangle abc, angle a is acute angle in such a way that ab is equal to c, bc is equal to a, and AC is equal to B due to union notation. You know that is known as union notation. Also, draw CD perpendicular to AB, where AD is the projection of AC on AB. We are not saying AB produced because it is inside AB. Previous, that was outside AB, so that was AB produced. But here in this case,
Dear students, again listen. A triangle ABC is acute angle triangle with acute angle at A such that AB is equal to C, BC is equal to A, AC is equal to B. Draw CD perpendicular to AB such that AD is equal to X, where AD is projection of AC on AB. So that was given. To prove is BC square is equal to AB square plus AC square minus 2AB into AD. Again, to prove BC square, the square of the side opposite to acute angle is equal to sum of squares of the two sides of angle. Diminished with twice as one side and perpendicular on the other. So here is, to prove is BC square is equal to AB square plus AC square minus 2AB into AD. Or you can say A square is equal to B square plus C square minus 2CX. To prove is A square is equal to B square plus C square minus 2CX. Dear students, you can check now. Proof. Statements. And reasons. Statements and reasons. In case of statement, in triangle CBA, again, in triangle CDA, and CD is equal to H also, okay, yes, in triangle CDA, angle CDA is equal to 90 degree, CDA is equal to 90 degree. CDA is equal to 90 degree, therefore, what is that? This is angle 90 degree. So opposite to 90 degree is always hypotenuse. So here is AC square is equal to AD square plus CD square. Pythagoras theorem. So dear students, we have AC square mean B square is equal to X square plus H square. This is number one. B square is equal to X square plus H square. Now we can write triangle CDB. In right triangle CDB, angle CDB is equal to 90 degree. So it is right angle triangle. So you can apply here again Pythagoras theorem. This is 90 degree. Opposite to 90 degree, this side is hypotenuse. So in case of hypotenuse, we can have BC square is equal to BD square and plus CD square. Yes, BC square is equal to BD square plus CD square. Here we can have BC square, or rather you can apply its value. What is BC square? BC mean A. Here is A. A square is equal to C minus X whole square plus X square. C minus X whole square plus X square. Open up the formula of square. A square is equal to C square plus X square minus 2CX plus H square. Remember that we can write down A square is equal to C square minus 2CX plus X square plus H square. Remember that X square plus H square. There again, just like theorem number 1, X square plus H square is equal to B square. So by using this value here, a square is equal to c square minus 2cx plus b square. So dear students, that was your to prove a square is equal to b square plus c square minus 2cx. That is your theorem number 8.2. I hope that you understood this theorem number 2. They are very easy, but they have a little resemblance. In both theorems, we have used 2-time Pythagoras theorem, because in both theorems we have two right-angled triangle and we have used 2-time Pythagoras theorem. Secondly, in first theorem, obtuse angle greater than 90 degree was given. In theorem number 2, acute angle less than 90 degree was given. In both theorems, a square is equal to b square plus c square, that is common part in both. A square is equal to b square plus c square, and a square is equal to b square plus c square in theorem number 2 also. In first theorem, that was plus 2cx, and second theorem, that was minus 2cx. So dear students, there is a resemblance, and even you can memorize one theorem and it will be very helpful for you to memorize the other theorem with the help of previous theorem. So I hope that you understood that one, and chapter number 8, theorem 1 and 2 finished. Inshallah, we will do our exercise question in next meeting, and you can revise at home, because I want to complete such portion of your books so that we can easily make the paper according to board pattern. So dear students, stay blessed and work hard and revise at home. And this is very, very important for you people, because this time when you are giving 10th class exam, definitely you will get 2 years result, including 9th class syllabus, your result also. So be careful and be conscious about your syllabus for VM. And if you have any problem, contact me and inshallah we will do it and we can solve your problem. Okay, Allah Hafiz and Assalamu Alaikum.